so many people neglect that. But that right there can take the game to the next level. What's up, YouTube? Welcome to the channel. I hope you guys are all having an incredible day. Right now, I'm off to training. I'm just gonna go get Marcus really quickly, and I'll catch you guys then. Marcus, today we're gonna do some dribbling and then we're gonna go to the gym after and get some squats, bench press and some rows. We got the poles back there today. We didn't get the poles incorporated yesterday. Yesterday was just like more of like a sprinting session, which that's what there was not a lot of shit with the ball. But today we're on the ball and I'm pretty sure we got nets. Yeah.
Yeah, we got nets.
So that's pretty sick. Yeah, cool. We'll see you after. Peace. Yes, guys, so this is how we usually start our training session, with passing on both feet, just so we can get some one-touch passes on the ground driven at each other. And we also do strong foot. Since Marcus is left-footed and I'm right-footed, we can do strong foot passing across each other, and we can also do it on our weak foot. This helps us with one-touch passing on the floor, so that in-game situations, we can have a good release of the ball on the floor. We've been waiting, anticipate a change coming our way. You're my baby, through the bad nights to the brighter days. I know that something good is waiting just around the corner. There's a new day dawning, there's a new life for us. Got to keep on holding on for just a little longer, I know. But it's gonna be blue skies for you and I. We'll step out of the shadows and walk into the light. Yeah, it's gonna be blue. Then we went into some one touch. First of all, this is just a bit of fun, but it also helps with your first touch and manipulation of the ball. As you can see, I'm hitting it with my heel and so is he. This is just so that we can get touches in different parts of our foot and become more comfortable on the ball. This is one of our first times doing this because for the last 3 months we've been doing 1,000 juggles a day individually. This is a challenge that we got from Become Elite. It's on YouTube if you want to search it up. It helped a lot with just our getting comfortable with the ball and juggling. This is how we can do this so comfortably now. It's a really good way to warm up. It's very fun. If you guys want to give it a go, go ahead. Then we went into some footwork plus finish drill. We usually start with this drill before our dribbling session, just so we can get some fitness in before we actually get into our dribbling session. As you notice, the other person says go before they start running towards the cones, and that's simply just so you can work on your reaction time, so that you don't know when you're supposed to go. Just like how football is very unpredictable, this drill is very unpredictable because you never know when you're gonna go. We had some questionable finishes in this drill, but overall, I think we did well. Then we went to the other side so that Marcus can get some strong foot shots in and I can get some weak foot shots in. He banged some in on these and I had some questionable finishes. But again, I thought we both did pretty well. Then we moved into our first dribbling drill. This drill may not look like it, but it is very exhausting. We got the first one from Become Elite. It's taking a lot of touches as many as you can through the cones, and then you will see that we try to go through it as fast as we can, and we also try to go through it with both feet. Right now I'm doing as fast as I can with Become Elite dribbling, so as many touches as I can. And what we also got very unlucky with our finishes. As you can see, I just smashed the crossbar. Also, we both had a shot that was going top bins, but it curled out in the last second. Here, Marcus is going, gets a good pass in there, checks his shoulder. We were always checking our shoulder before we received that ball back, before going through the cones. Here, he's going through. Let's see how his finish is here. He's running. Step overs are good. Good pass. The release is good. And the finish? On point, very good finish. They never believed in me, but I never believed them. And I ain't here for the cash though, I'm just here for the freedom. Right through in a hatchback, juked out in that all black, move 5-2 on a snapback. Cause I moved that, son, I own that. That's empire, that's building up. Got a lot, but can't get enough. Hot dog, and I'm catching up. Y'all better start on resting up. We the ones, who you to us. You a liability, bitches kill me. You were blind to it, now you feel me. That's braille, that's real. Doing bigger numbers than your major deal. You still thinking you a major deal. Took a dream, then I took it overseas. And y'all even playing in the field. From 307, homie. Y'all ain't even get it, homie. They ain't done this like this where I'm from. Went home, I seen rappers coming up. Look at what we did, doing what we done. I went home, everybody showing love. It's a whole new world showing up. What's a whole different vibe going up? Went home just to open up a show. Little lick in me, I was on a roll. Crew with me, supposed to get him in for free. Bouncer with the tickets in on me. Snapped on him like old decks on 5-0 grinds. Second that, I realized how much that the ego blinds. Apologize for that, my bad, I must lost my cap. Everybody got a dark side, sometimes the empire gotta strike back. But I feel like I'm the new hope. Episode 2, y'all be the clones. My future set in that carbonite like I'm Han Solo. Used to trip on my X thing, now mob through like an X-Wing. I'm so galactic, so galactic. Came here to swallow up the planet. Modern Marvel, hero villain. These days I can't tell the difference. These days I'm on something different. I'm so involved with my current mission. They say, tell us what we don't know. Got flows kicking like a dojo. It was all a hunchback thing, Quasimodo. Hit me up for features, but I'm dying with the quote though. Then we moved on to this drill. In this drill, you check and then you receive a ball in the air that the other person throws to you. Then you go through the three cones, play it to the partner, receive it back, play it back, go to the other side of the pole, receive it again, go to the other, through the other cones, and then repeat again on the other side. Then you turn around and come back and you receive the ball from your partner, turn, and go towards goal. Right now, we're in the city center. Yesterday it got too late, so we couldn't go to the gym. We still did a workout in his backyard, but the footage is disgraceful. So we're gonna go to the gym right now. You know that I miss you, I wanna get with you tonight, but I cannot, baby girl, and that's the issue. Girl, you know I miss you, I just wanna kiss you, but I can't right now, so baby, kiss me through the phone. So we started our gym session with some bench press. This exercise is very good for your upper body and your chest in general. When I started doing this exercise, I was very weak. I was doing about 60 pounds, but now as you can see, I'm doing about 125 pounds. This is a big motivation for me because knowing that I'm adding more weight and getting stronger is what keeps me going to keep on going to the gym and getting better and stronger every single time I go. Flat. Then we moved on to some squats. Now squats are very important to play football because you need to have strong legs to be able to explode and shoot.
I've been consistently adding more weight to my squats, and I'm up to 165 pounds now. My goal is to have very strong legs so I can not get pushed off the ball and so I can be the fastest player on the pitch every single time I step onto a pitch. I do 5 sets of 5 and Marcus does 4 sets of 8. The reason I do 5 sets of 5 is so that I can get really explosive and heavy squats so that I can work on my explosion movements, and he just wants to improve his technique and become better at squats. Alright, then we moved on to some deadlifts. Now deadlifts I hate, but I still do them because I want to get my hamstrings stronger and I want to be able to explode more on the pit. I keep adding more weight to the deadlift, but I feel like every time I add more weight to the deadlift, it's about 10 times harder. This time I added about 5 more pounds and I'm pretty sure that I'm gonna feel it tomorrow. Then we moved on to some balance exercises. Now this is neglected by a lot of people that I know personally, but it's one of the most important things that you have to work on in football. Because if you think about it, most of the things you do on the pitch involves balance. So we do not shy away from doing balance exercises and just becoming better with our balance on the field, because that's very important.
Session's over.
Get sash.
Yeah, we started with some treadmill, then we went into some running. How'd you find the deadlift?
Deadlifts, it was tough, but you know, it's just gonna help you at the end of the day.
Yeah, I think I fucking hate deadlifts. Deadlifts, every single time after I do a deadlift, I feel like I wanna kill myself. I don't know why. How about the bench press?
Bench press?
You went a little bit heavier. You said it the same way, didn't you?
Yeah, I don't know. My chest is pretty pathetic right now. Just gotta keep working at it.
Yeah. You did put more weight on the squat, right?
On the squats, yeah. I was up to like 140 or something.
Yeah.
It's not too bad.
Yeah, well, you just gotta keep putting more and more weight every time. Once you get used to the weight, you should start putting more weight on so that your muscles can adapt to a new weight. Me, I stayed pretty much at the same weight that I've been doing for like a couple of weeks now, which is not a bad thing. It just means that I gotta keep working at it. But yeah, right now we're gonna get a smoothie and then we'll talk after.
Yeah.
Peace! Guys, back here, we just had a smoothie, just came back from the gym. And we were talking and we were like, we know so many people that like neglect squats. And like, these people, like they're like their balance and like their like just strength. That like their core strength or just their strength of their legs is terrible, and it's so easy to push them off the ball. And like there's so many people like our age especially that just don't do them. And like we see like people like become elite that does them a lot, and like
it helps you with like your explosiveness, like your first 5 steps when you're running for the ball, or
yeah, and you're like you're vertical, and all that kind of stuff. And like just like the people that we know that don't do their squats, like how what do you think about them?
I don't know. Their balance is, I guess, is questionable, and their strength in their legs.
Yeah. So do your squats, because if you don't, you're just gonna be skinny. Like you look at Riyad Mahrez. I doubt he does any squats. But if you're gonna be like somebody that's like really really skinny, you've got to have technique. Like Riyad Mahrez's technique is incredible, and just like. Is just like his body just looks like it's made to be skinny and play football. But like you look like a Ronaldo. If Ronaldo didn't have like strong legs, like what would he be? Like, you know, he wouldn't have any power in his legs to run or to shoot. So do your squats, don't neglect the gym side of football, or else you're not really gonna make it to the top, especially if you're not like in an academy. If you're not doing like your gym work and then you go to like a trial, you're gonna get battered off the ball. And that's just the truth about it.
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna end the video here.
I hope you enjoyed it. Smash the thumbs up button and subscribe if you liked it. We'll see you guys next time.
Peace.